So listen up, I already know what you're thinking. CG Matter, you nerd, did you really set up a green screen on a table with bad lighting and everything? Yeah, I did. Okay, we're trying out a new format. Get over it. So muzzle flashes, we are going to be making muzzle flashes. In fact, we're going to be making procedural ones so that there's no reason for you to go through Google Images and just download garbage photos that, you know, are either low resolution, have something in the background, are the wrong color, or I don't even know what other kinds of mistakes can happen on Google Images. And in the spirit of making action essentials and action VFX and all these pieces of stock footage you don't need to buy, again, we're going to be making these procedural, meaning that you can make as many muzzle flashes as you want using this technique. And paired with the last tutorial I made about smoke puffs, you know, we talked about making smoke puffs, this should be good in combination. And the way we're gonna be doing it is using a lot of nodes, a lot of shading, and I can see why that would be intimidating to a lot of people who are bad at math. In which case, I would say I already made a long tutorial about how to do this, so just watch that tutorial. Honestly, I don't know what you're gonna get from this tutorial. This is just kind of an overview. If you wanna know what's going on, go watch the previous tutorial. This is just gonna be a mess. It's gonna be a big mess, okay? So the first thing we need to do, of course, is open up Blender. I'm going to be using version 2.81, but you could probably go back all the way to like 2.0001. It should be compatible. And what we're going to do is we're going to take the default cube and just, you know, we're just going to get rid of it. We're going to delete it. And then we need to replace this with something that we're going to put our texture on. So I'm just going to be using a plane. And again, the point of this is we're going to be putting our muzzle flash that we're creating on that plane. You know, if you can think of this as where we're putting our, I mean, I guess this is just my script. I script everything out on the back. On the back of an April tag. Now in the shading workspace, we're just gonna be doing a bunch of steps that give us our muzzle flash. And the first thing is gonna be making a circle. We're then gonna be stretching that out into an oval. And then we're gonna be tapering that off into this kind of sideways teardrop or something. Again, just turning this ellipse into something that's more muzzle flash shaped. We can then add in a bit of noise to distort this so it doesn't look all smoothed out, but it actually looks like this explosive, detailed thing that you probably want. So again, circle, oval, doing our distortion into a teardrop and then adding a bit of detail with noise. And then really the last step is just adding some colors to this. So you could do the traditional, you know, orange, red, yellow, green, blue. And then we can also control the brightness of this kind of as if we're deciding the exposure of the camera or something. And again, I can't stress enough that all of this is covered in an in-depth tutorial that's actually a tutorial. So go check that out if any of this doesn't make sense. So starting off making our circle, the easiest way to do this is by using a gradient texture node. So again, gradient texture node, set it to something like, I don't know, spherical. Set it to something like, I don't know, spherical or quadratic sphere, anything with the word sphere in it. And then for the texture coordinates, we're just going to be using object coordinates, which actually centers it on our plane. And I said the next step is we're going to be taking this circle and kind of stretching it out. We're going to be stretching it out into an oval, and you could either mess with texture coordinates to do that, or what I like to do is, you know, just take the plane we made and then scale it horizontally, which stretches our circle into an ellipse. And now to turn this into the kind of teardrop shape we were talking about, we're basically going to be messing with the texture coordinates by first separating the texture coordinates and then combining them. So effectively nothing has changed. We split, we combine, but in between is where we want to be doing all our messy work. And really the point is we want to be stretching this thing vertically. You know, as we move from left to right on the x-axis, we want it to be stretching vertically. So what we're going to do is we're just going to take this y component and then multiply it by the x component, which of course we then need to modify so it doesn't look like hot garbage. And really the idea we're going to be using here is taking our x input and modifying it with a map range node. Again, that's the node that takes some interval, right? You have some interval and then it maps it to a different one. So especially since we're using object coordinates, which has negative values, we just take this interval and then map it to a 0 to 1 interval. And then we can take this and run it through an RGB curves, which is where we can manually adjust the shape of this. You know, this is kind of like being able to decide the profile visually. And then to have this make a bit more sense, we can actually use another math node to take the reciprocal of that RGB curve. So again, we were first taking the RGB curves, now we're taking the reciprocal, which means when we take a point on the curve and lower it, it's gonna shrink that part in our muzzle flash. So this now gives us our lips, which is now tapered off in the way that we want it to. So it's more in the shape of a muzzle flash. And now all we need to do is add in a bit of noise. And to do that, we're just gonna add in a noise node, combine it using some vector math. And then of course we need to displace it. Again, all this is covered in detail in the in-depth tutorial. I don't know how many times I can tell you guys that. But the whole point of using this noise texture is that we can again control everything about it. We can control the detail, we can control the scale to get different types of muzzle flashes. We can even turn it into 4D, so we're working in four dimensions, which lets us create new variations using this W slider. I am starting to overheat. I'm gonna take this hat off. So we've now dealt with all the texture coordinate stuff, which lets us reshape our initial gradient texture. And now finally, like I said, we need to do our coloring. And to do this, just add in a color ramp node, add some colors to the handles, you know, whatever realistic explosion-y oranges and yellows you want. And of course, we're gonna set the interpolation to something that's a bit smoother, like B-spline, and just keep playing around with this until you like whatever color combination you come up with. And like I said, we can add a bit more control to this by adding a math node before the color ramp set to multiply, and we can just bring that side to side to control what is essentially, you can think of it as the exposure. And that's pretty much all there is to it. So hopefully I went through all the steps that were actually necessary in this workflow, because I didn't really look at my script and I'm not using the computer to look at what I'm filming, and none of this makes sense anymore, and I should probably just end this tutorial. Hopefully this new format isn't awful. We'll see. So the first thing we need to do, of course, and then to have this make a bit more